Hello. So good to meet you at this daily motivational meeting. We're reading the World Scripture book to inspire a positive vibe for the day. This book empowers billions of people, families, communities, cities, countries, and the whole world, and will help you to just read them and practice. As we're reading all the book from the beginning, please find all the chapters on our Message to Billion channel. And get more inspiration and salvation. Now we are reading about the last days. Let's read further about new revelation. The revelatory phenomena of the last days begin with the spiritual awakening. The 20th century saw the birth of Pentecostalism, exhibiting speaking in tongues and other phenomena of the first Christian church. Throughout the world, many new sects have arisen based on the special revelations to their founders. This spiritual awakening takes many forms, East and West. Moreover, in the Jewish and Christian scriptures, there are hints that God will reveal deeper aspects of His truth in the last days. They indicate that the humankind's current state of knowledge of God's truth is imperfect and clouded by error. What of Islam, Buddhism, and other religions? Truth is inexcusable. Yet the dispute over doctrines and teachings among the various denominations and sects have plagued each of the world's great faith traditions. It stands to reason that in the last days, a new expression of truth will come to clarify distinction truth from error, put an end to religious disputes, and guide all humankind on the path to God. It may be inevitable that many believers attached to conventional doctrines will reject the new truth when it will appear, as has happening at the birth of every religion. Nevertheless, if the truth is broad enough to embrace the essential teachings of all the world religions with respect and appreciation, it should attract the support from all quarters and not become the base of yet another new sect. The perfect and complete truth will be revealed. I have said this to you in figures. The hour is coming when I shall no longer speak to you in figures, but tell you plainly of the Father. For our knowledge is imperfect and our prophecy is imperfect, but when the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up a childish way. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall understand fully. For each faith community, we have appointed a divine law and treated out way. Unto God, you will all return, and He will then inform you of that wherein you differ. What is the difference between our time and the Messianic time? Purity and attainment of knowledge. I have yet many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of Truth comes, He will guide you into all the truth, for He will not speak on His own authority, but whatever He hears, He will speak, and He will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify Me, for He will take what is Mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has in mind, therefore I say that He will take what is Mine and declare it to you. And in the last days it shall be, God declares, that I will pour out My Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons, your daughters shall prophesy, and you young men shall see visions, and you old men shall dream dreams. Yeah, on My manservant and My menstruants in the, those days. I will pour out my spirit and they shall prophesy. Yeah, so interesting. That's why we are here. And your sons and daughters shall prophesy. We prophesy every morning. And God say, let there be light. And there was light. Although God spoke these words to the dwell of the earth, then light refers to the light made for the world to come. The original light that God created was the higher light, the light to the eye. The Holy One gave Adam a glimpse of it, and at a glance, he saw the entire world. When David beheld it, he was transported to spiritual ecstasy and exclaimed, "Oh, how abundant is thy goodness!" It was by this light that God showed Moses the promised land from Gilead to them. Yet from the beginning, this divine light was hidden and concealed. As God perceived that the generations of men who lived in the times of Noah and of the Tower of Babel would use it for selfish purpose. Rabbi Isaac said, the light created by God in the work of creation filled the world with its splendor, but was eventually withdrawn and concealed. Why? So that the transgression of the good law might not participate in it. Therefore, the Holy One conceals and preserves it for the days of the righteous one, the Messiah, as it is written, light dawns for the righteous one. When it shall prevail again throughout the world, humanity will become renewed and live the higher life and become one with an angelic life. Until then, however, this divine light is concealed in darkness, which is its covering. Further, let's read quotes from the Second Messiah, Father and Moon. The Bible renders important parts of the truth in symbols and parables. Since these are open to various interpretations, there have arisen numerous disagreements among believers, causing them to divide into many denominations. The primary cause of denomination division lies in the character of the Bible, not in the people. The strife between denominations will only grow more intractable unless a new truth emerges which can elucidate the symbols and parables obscuring the essential truth of the Bible. Without this new truth, God's providence, which comes through the unification of Christianity, can never reach its goal. This is why Jesus promises that in the last day, he will give us the new word of truth. I have said this unto you in figures. Then hours is coming when I shall not no longer speak to you in figures, but tell you plainly of the Father. Due to the disbelief of the people of his time, Jesus died on the cross without being able to teach all that was in his heart. As he said, if I have told you earlier things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you heavenly things? What is more, Jesus added, I have yet many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now, disclosing how sorrowful he was about the inability of even his closest disciple to receive all that he wanted to share. Nevertheless, the words that Jesus left unspoken will not remain forever a secret, but one day will be divulged through the Holy Spirit as a new expression of truth. As Jesus said, when the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into the old truth, nor for he will not speak on his own authority, but wherever he hears, speak, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. Because the human beings fell, God's words of promise could not appear as the word of fulfillment. That was the cause in the Old Testament and the New Testament, which contain promises of a world yet to appear, the world of fulfillment. The lack of this word is a most serious matter. All humanity, faithful believers seeking heaven, should consider this problem. It is a problem of Christianity, and it is a problem of anyone who would attempt to unify all the world's religions. Why is the world today full of division and strife? When Jesus appeared in the world, it also was beset with division. Jesus' word was meant to end the division and strife. However, because the people of that time did not believe in Jesus' word, the problems that he came to resolve were not entirely resolved. That is why today there should appear the complete Testament word to bring order to this world filled with divisions and strife, and to unite all doctrines and teachings. Amazing things occur in the first church, speaking in tongues, spiritual works, prophesying, and more. These same spiritual phenomena will emerge in Christian history in the last days. Many who experience these things will be called crazy and heretics. Yet the upon whom the Spirit has been poured out cannot contest it. He may not know why it happens, but heaven will tell them him. He opens his eyes to see the spirit world. His actions are the actions of spiritual beings. He sees things and behaves totally different from you. To you, he may appear insane, but consider, did Jesus look like an intelligent man in the eyes of the contemporaries? He was a united fool. In the future, such spiritual phenomena will occur, will sweep across the world and the people of the churches. Among the disciples of Jesus, there was not one who was overly attached to the Old Testament scriptures. Rather, they all responded to the spiritual experiences which they sense it through their inner minds. In the last days, people who lead an ardent life of prayer or who live by their conscience will feel intense anxiety in their hearts. This is because in their hearts they vaguely sense a spiritual calling and want to follow the providence of the new age. Yet they have not come in contact with the new truth which can guide them to act accordingly. These are the chosen one who, once they hear the new truth, will be awakened simultaneously in their spirit and intellects by spirit and truth. They will then fully understand God's providential needs concerning the new age and will volunteer with great enthusiasm and delight. We who are alive today are living in the last days. We should cultivate a humble heart and make the utmost effort to receive divine inspiration through prayer. We should not be strongly attached to conventional concepts, but rather should direct ourselves to the receptive to the Spirit in order that we may find the new truth which can guide us to the providence of the new age. So powerful quotes for today. If you have difficulties today, please watch one more time this video. Share this video as we end this billion happy life subscribers marathon. Contact me for consultation, cooperation, and become a member of this Heavenly Parents community globally. And see you tomorrow with more powerful quotes. All the best. Bye-bye. Yours, Coach Nikolai Serpov.